I'm delighted to say that this conference is featuring a special focus on Latin America and the Caribbean. And yesterday, I'm very pleased to say, over 70 people, journalists and others, participated from over 14 countries, participated in an annual training workshop supported and funded by the Fundación Eli Ortiz from Mexico. And now it is my distinct pleasure to introduce you to Enrique Bustamante Martinez, the executive director of the Fundación Eli Ortiz, for a few more welcoming remarks. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Chris, for this warm welcome and congratulations for your work as a president all these years. Thank you as well, Ron and Chris, also directors and organizers of this World Conference. My name is Enrique Bustamante Martinez. Vengo de la Ciudad de México y soy el director de la Fundación Eli Ortiz. Good afternoon, science journalists, researchers, and communicators from all over the world. It is a privilege for me to address all of you at the beginning of this 10th World Conference on Science Journalists. It is wonderful to meet so many colleagues from so many countries who are attending this event, which is focused on strengthening the area of journalism that is so significant today. On behalf of Mr. Juan Francisco Eli Ortiz, the Chairman Executive Officer of El Universal, the oldest and the most important newspaper in Mexico, I bring you our best wishes for this important global event. Let's bridging science and societies. I arrive here today with a good news about the extraordinary workshop that we conducted yesterday with more than 75 science journalists and communicators from 14 countries in Latin America and the Caribbean. In addition, two participants and people from United States, United Kingdom, Australia, and Spain. At the Jack F. Ely Science Journalism Workshop, we discuss the framework for a regional science journalism network which will encourage reporters to cross international borders and work together on stories that have far-reach impact in Latin America and the Caribbean. We think the world should take notice. Latin America is taking the lead, but challenging each of you to begin building a science journalist network in your region. Knowledge is only value when it's shared. I urge you to unite, to work across borders, to share with scientific knowledge that you are gathering through your reporting with people in your region. There is a strength in numbers, and our numbers are great. In this ballroom today, we have more than 1,200 science journalists and communicators. Just think what we can do if we work together. This is a vision that we guide us at the Eli Ortiz Foundation since we launched our professional training program for science and scientific journalists in 2004. Over the past 13 years, we have carried out 35 workshops in separate editions: Latin America edition, the Mexico edition, the UNAM edition, and the Europe edition. We have granted more than 1,600 scholarships to journalists from all Latin America countries, and we have invited more than 400 lecturers from Nobel Prize winners, researchers, academics, business leaders, to government officials. In addition, we have created, together with the National Autonomous University of Mexico, the first master's in communication degree with a specialization in science journalism. All this make us feel very proud, but also it commit us to continue in this process of encouraging the work of science journalists in Latin America and the Caribbean. We are certain that the relationship between science and journalism is more important now than ever. Reporting on science takes skills. The tools to teach these skills are available. But we need more universities that offer graduate degrees in science journalism to train the next generation of reporters and editors. We need science to be a regular part of the curriculum of journalism schools. We need editors-in-chiefs who encourage their journalists to get more training through conferences, forums, summits, courses or workshops like those we organize at the Ilio Ortiz Foundation, particularly in developing countries where science discoveries and technological innovations are having an increasing impact. The training of science journalists is crucial. We need this because the increasing demand for science and technology coverage, given the growing interest of our readers, listeners, TV viewers, and cybernauts. In modern society, it's the time for us to think about what science journalism actually provides. Everyone in this room knows perfectly that science journalism is no longer about only physics or chemistry or biology. Instead, the audience of the 21st century understands that we are living in the post-industrial revolution, and they want to read about the science that is personal and relevant to them, whether related to the latest cure of the cancer or just a general update on diet and dietary recommendations. It is, therefore, the role of a science journalist in this modern era to ensure that scientific research is represented in an accurate manner. In order that achieve, the science journalist must have a high level of science knowledge. This is about the importance of the work that you do every day. The significance of a single story can have in a changing the way of millions of people feed themselves or in promoting hygiene to help prevent an epidemic. We must promote stories that help us to take care of so many animal species that are now in danger of extinction, or prevent forests from disappearing, or raise the silent voice of our planet, which today asks us to have greater individual awareness. We know the climate change is evident and is the result of so many individual actions that, upon repeating over and over again, contaminate, destroy, and endanger the stability of the nature. It is for all these reasons that I applaud this fact that we are here today. Today, we can contribute, that we can raise a voice regarding topics that are borderless and have no nationality, skin color, or region. Air, water, animal, and forest do not have a flag. They belong to the air, and our children will appreciate that our work here is really useful. Before I close, I would like to thank Rosalind Reed, Executive Director of the Council for Advancement of Science Writing, and the whole team of the World Conference of Scientists Journalists for this great opportunity to strengthen science journalism. I will also like to thank Lynn Walker, Executive Director of Inquire First, for being an unconditional ally since the beginning of the Jack Feili workshops in 2004. Together, we have managed to turn a dream into a great reality. On behalf of Mr. Juan Francisco Ili Ortiz and myself, thanks to all of the science journalists around the world and to their media organizations for making so much essential information known by people around the world. Join us, your colleagues in Latin America, in building bridges as strong, as beautiful as the Golden Gate, to tell the world the stories that only science journalists can tell. There is nothing we can achieve if we work together. When we meet again at 2019 World Conference of Science Journalists, let's celebrate the fact that we have a science journalism network in every region of the world. Till then, let's keep working in this amazing field of science journalism. But at the same time, let's create those networks to improve the lives of millions of people across the globe. Thank you very much.